Good evening, students. Let us continue our chapter. What? Granny's little laptop. We have already covered four stanzas of this poem. We have explained a lot the meanings. I have already written and told you to underline and write down the meanings and learn it. Clear? Now, let us continue the other stanzas. Hopefully, you will not get any doubt here because sentences literally vary simple and clear meaning. Okay. Now, after the fourth stanza, in fifth stanza, let us see what is there. She'll engage in quickery forums. You have heard this one, just underline, because it can come that granny, how do granny is involved? Involved in what social medias, or you can say that with the laptop, how she is involving herself with the laptop and all. So you have to list down all these activities, what she is doing, okay, how she is utilizing the modern technology, not only the laptop. She got the laptop, she learned it, and after that how she is utilizing the laptop, that is very important. So each and every stanza we got each and points we have to list down first, that what she is doing with the laptop or how she is utilizing the laptop. Clear? So in the fifth stanza we got that she is using quickery forums, and what for that reason she have a million fans asking for her recipes of fish curries and flans. Now see, flans in your book you will get the meaning. Okay, what is that? It's a kind of pie or cake mix up with cheese and fruit. Okay, flans. So as she is involving in quickery forums, so her motive is that to share dishes, recipes. Granny is like that only. So she is having million fans for that recipes, specially for what? Specially for curries and flans. Okay, this 2 points we will write down here. Recipes, first one, fish curry, second one, flans. Now you can write flans also, but it will be better if you write down the meaning of that. This kind of pie or cake filled up with cheese or fruits. Clear? So fifth stanza, very clear. Fifth stanza, she is engaging herself in the quickery forums to share her recipes, specially fish curries and flans. Clear? Let us come to the next stanza. She'll keep the world begging for her poetry and prose. See the word she used here, begging. Means what? If we are have our focus, or it's a kind of hobby, is it, writing poetry, poems and all. Okay, so granny is also having this kind of habit or hobby, you can say, to write poetry and prose, and that also she is sharing. So she's telling that how famous I am, you see, that people are begging me for my poetry and poems. For her masterpiece in Egyptology is a study for language, culture, history of Egypt. You heard that place, Egypt. Okay, so specially she is writing poetry and prose based on Egyptology for the stories that she knows. Now, we know that history is very important, is it? One of the important subjects. Now, history, if you see your great-grandfather or mother, your grandfather or mother, means your grandparents are actually have depth on that subject, history. They knew it very well. So, granny is also having a grip or depth knowledge about Egyptology. So the point she wants to share, that is her masterpiece, that is Egyptology, study about the Egypt, the people of that place, Egyptians and all, how they are living, their culture, their studies, their history behind this. This all she used to share, okay, where? On that social media, and writing specially on that topic, poetries, prose and all. Okay, so she is very famous. we can say that she is very famous in social medias. By using technology, she not only famous for her recipes, but also for her blogs, for her prose, poetries. Okay, these all things are there. She all around actually very famous. So the sixth stanza, nothing is there. Here we come to know that she is writing poetry and prose, specially based on Egyptology and all. Clear? The last stanza, it is written, so get set darling granny. It's a just a greet for granny. She is darling. We are so happy you are online. So as granny is using the technology, so we are also very happy and welcoming her as she is online. You are a granny in a million. I'm so glad you are mine. So the poet is telling that as you are my granny, so I'm very proud. I'm feeling very proud to get you as my granny, because you are so upgraded and updated. Is it using the technology, utilizing it properly, having millions of fans and all, and eventually you are also in million, one only. Clear? So poet is telling that I am here. I means who is the writer. Okay, here the poet is telling that I am so happy to get you as my granny and I am so proud. Clear? So it's just a simple poem. Here some meanings you have to write. It can come short questions and all. Okay, history, Egyptology, history, culture of Egypt. So before also I have written some words and all that also you will learn, and today is also this all. And as we have finished this poem, your work first, go through the full poem. After that you have to write down the summary of the poem. I'm writing here, what summary of the poem.
Hello.
So you will write down the summary of the poem. That is your homework. You will write down in your copy the summary of the poem. Literally the poem is very easy. Okay, after that you will just add that though granny belongs to the generation, different generation from nowadays, but then also she is very updated and she is very modernized with the modern technology. Clear? That line you just add at the last of the poem. Clear? So the poem we have finished. About the discussion, about the meaning and all. One class more I will take for the question answer, and the lines I will mention for the explanations. Clear? That which line you have to explain, like 2-3 lines all together I will give you, and it will be written that answer the questions given below with reference of the context. Clear? And each question carries 5 marks, like that. We'll practice how to write explanations. I'll say how to write within 3 paragraphs. We'll write it first, the introduction of the lines from where it has taken. Secondly, we'll write the literal meaning of the sentence. Thirdly, we'll write the inner meaning of the sentence. So like this we'll write down the explanation. One demo I'll give you how to write the explanations, and like this only you will write at your home in your copy. And more than this, already in your exercise, if you go through, you'll see that kind of questions are already there. Okay, 3 questions are already there, like that more 2-3 lines I'll add there. Okay, in my next class I'll just discuss about the question answer. Though poetry is very easy literally, but while you'll do the question answer, you'll get the problems. Clear? Because explanation is not so easy. So I'll discuss about this, how to write reference with the context and all. That much only. So you just go through the poem, try to understand the meaning, write down the summary of the poem, and that's all. And if you are getting any problem, ask me, I'll definitely solve it. This much today. Thank you, class.